love him. Big thank you, Barry, and the team at TV Burke, for giving us that little nugget of comedy gold. Thank you so much. And we want to say a big thank you to ITV as well, because they're always very generous and gracious with their talent on and around Red Nose Day. So thanks a lot.
Yeah. Hey, Dave.
Yes.
I'm feeling a bit of a thank you coming on. Do you mind?
Go for it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you. If you've managed to pop out to a bookshop over the last few weeks, you might have picked up one of these brilliant books, Tracy Beaker's Thumping Heart and Mr. Funny's Red Nose Day. Both have raised crucial cash for Comedy Relief, and they're all still on sale, so go out tomorrow, buy 20 copies each. Thank you to Jacqueline Wilson and Adam Hargreaves and to everyone involved.
Now look, just a few weeks ago, Lenny Henry flew out to Uganda to visit a woman called Onzia, and with your money, Comic Relief are going to build her a new, safer house. But when Lenny arrived, he found out that Onzia had a much more serious problem.
Onzia is a widow. She's HIV positive and has two sons.
It must be tough living in conditions like this, particularly when it rains. What was it like with the children here?
But because of the terrible state of her house, Onzia had to send both her sons away to live with relatives so they wouldn't get sick too.
So when was the last time she saw her children?
7 years.
I was stunned yesterday when Onzia told me that she hadn't seen her children for 7 years. Imagine that. Imagine not being able to watch your children grow up because you were too ill and scared that they might get sick because of terrible living conditions, and so the only option is to send them away. Well, I've got some good news that might make a huge difference to Onzia's life.
The local project that Comic Relief works with has tracked down Onzia's boys.
Lenny, nice to meet you.
How are you?
I'm very well, how are you?
What are you doing?
We're going to take a trip.
Here comes the sun.
The two boys were living 200 kilometres away, and now the project are bringing them to see their mum, and I'm joining them for the final leg of their journey. The boys have had to live apart. One child has been looked after by his step-grandmother, but the long separation has taken its toll, particularly on 14-year-old Abraham. Whereas 12-year-old Joshua is much more confident and wants to test me on my knowledge of science.
Give the condition necessary for photosynthesis.
Give the condition necessary for photosynthesis. A shower, perhaps. Maybe dinner and a movie first. Sorry. The three conditions: sunlight, chlorophyll. You have to have chlorophyll running through your leaves. You need to be a thing with leaves in the ground. I think Ibrahim's staying well out of this.
Ibrahim, how are you feeling about seeing your mum?
Happiness.
You haven't lived with her for a long time. How are you feeling about seeing your mum?
I'm going to be very happy.
Oh, great.
Finally, we arrive on the outskirts of the city. And at last, the years and years of waiting for Onzia and her sons is over. Time and again, Comic Relief has helped bring families together, like these sisters who thought they'd lost each other forever. Your Comic Relief money has helped bring home the loneliest children back into their parents' arms.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
seems to me that this is the most extraordinary thing you can do. Reunite a family. And you can do it again, tonight. Look around at your kids, at your family. Imagine losing them and getting them back. You can make that happen tonight. You know the number. And if you want to donate online, go to bbc.co.uk/rednosedaybThank you.
£25 and we can buy food for families for a whole fortnight. You give us £35 and we can pay for the salary for the person who brought those kids back home.